Welcome to the Marking History Channel. You will never know each week which historical marker and its story will be presented, but you will learn more about American history. So please hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell to get notified about our next video. And if you like this video, please leave a comment below and share with your friends. Now let's learn some history. Every July 4th, we celebrate our independence from British rule. As we eat our hot dogs, chug our beer, and watch the fireworks, let's review 13 facts about July 4th that you may not know. Next on Marking History. Here is the historical marker for the Declaration of Independence, with a replica of the actual document and its 56 signers. This marker is located here in front of the police department for the city of Hyattsville, Maryland. You know, you can't get more historical than the Declaration of Independence. And as an amateur historian of American history, it was difficult for me to choose only 13 facts. But here goes, my top 13 facts about Independence Day. When the 56 men signed the Declaration of Independence, they knew full well that they were committing treason against England, and they knew the penalty, death. In fact, it was Ben Franklin who said, "We must indeed all hang together, or most assuredly we shall hang separately." Signing the Declaration proved to be very costly. 5 signers were captured by the British and brutally tortured as traitors. 9 fought in the Revolutionary War and died from wounds or hardships. 2 lost their sons in the war, and 2 others had sons captured. At least a dozen of the 56 had their homes pillaged and burned. By 1776, we'd actually been working on declaring our independence for years. 1773. The Boston Tea Party took place as a protest against British taxation of colonial tea. 1774, the First Continental Congress began meeting to discuss what to do about Britain's imposing unfair laws on the colonies. 1775, the Revolutionary War began on April 19, 1775, with the battles at Lexington and Concord, and would continue until 1781. With America's victory at Yorktown, Virginia. 1776, June 28th, Founding Fathers presented the first rough draft of the document to the Second Continental Congress. Here is the famous John Trumbull painting depicting all of our Founding Fathers signing the Declaration of Independence on July 4th, 1776. Guess what? It never happened. No such scene with all the delegates present ever occurred in Philadelphia. That patriotic scene, printed on the back of the $2 bill, took place on June 28, 1776, when the 5 authors of the Declaration of Independence presented the first rough draft of the document to the Second Continental Congress and President John Hancock. In a significant day in American history, the Second Continental Congress voted for independence. The date was July 2nd, 1776. America's original 13 colonies had elected to separate from an English empire. It literally became the first day of the American Revolution. Over the next 2 days, 86 alterations were made to the draft, and Congress approved the document on July 4th. 1776. A fair copy was made of the amended draft and hand-carried by John Adams and Ben Franklin to the printing office of John Dunlap in Philadelphia on the afternoon of the 4th. The Declaration was printed that night into the early morning of the 5th. John Hancock, President of Congress, began to send out official copies on the 5th and 6th of July to all 13 colonies, ordering them to print the Declaration in their newspapers and generally distribute the news as they saw fit The final handwritten Declaration of Independence wasn't finished for weeks, and the delegates didn't sign it until August 2nd, 1776. Even then, not all delegates were in attendance, so some signed later. We all honor July 4th because of the date on top of our national document. You could say that July the 4th was the day that Congress went public with their revolution. More accurately, it was the day Congress approved of Thomas Jefferson and Company's final draft of the Declaration of Independence, after a frantic 2 days of writing and rewriting. That afternoon and evening, copies were printed in Philadelphia. Two men did sign early printed copies of the Declaration on July 4th. President of the Second Continental Congress, John Hancock, and his secretary, Charles Thompson. They both signed July 4th copies to be given to military officers and various political committees. The majority of the other 54 men signed the official copy on August 2nd, 1776, with others to follow at a later date. Two signers of the Declaration of Independence later became U.S. presidents. They were John Adams, our second president, and Thomas Jefferson, our third president. And they both died on the same day. They both died on July 4th, 1826, on the 50th anniversary of our independence. James Monroe, our fifth president, also died on July 4th, just a few years later. George Washington, representative from Virginia, never signed the Declaration of Independence. Why? Because he wasn't there. He was busy serving as the commanding general in the Continental Army. Another Virginian, Thomas Nelson, Jr., was elected to fill Washington's seat in the Second Continental Congress. So it was Nelson who signed the Declaration of Independence. Later, General Nelson served under General Washington during the siege of Yorktown. So here's a question: whose signature is the most valuable on the Declaration of Independence? So here's a clue: it is not John Hancock, Thomas Jefferson, or John Adams. The most valuable signature belongs to a businessman from Georgia, and his name is Button Gwinnett. He signed the famous document in 1776. 10 months later, he was killed in a duel with a political rival. Due to his life of obscurity and his untimely death, his signature is the rarest of the 56 signers, by far. According to experts, there are only 51 known signatures in existence by this forgotten founding father. And the fewer the signatures, the higher the value. His signature's value is considered to be up there with William Shakespeare. After years of pent-up frustration, the colonies let loose upon hearing the words of the Declaration of Independence in 1776. Military personnel and civilians in the Bowling Green section of Manhattan tore down a statue of King George III and later melted it into bullets. The king's coat of arms were used as kindling for a bonfire in Philadelphia, and in Savannah, Georgia, the citizens burnt the king in effigy and held a mock funeral for their royal foe. The 4th of July did not automatically become a national holiday in 1776. It took almost a century for Congress to make it official. Congress made Independence Day an official unpaid holiday for federal employees in 1870, along with Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's Day. In 1938, Congress changed Independence Day to a paid federal holiday for employees of the federal government.
Although the Fair Labor Standards Act does not mandate that public sector employers pay their workers for time not worked, most offer a company benefit with a paid holiday on July 4th. At the Second Continental Congress during the summer of 1776, Thomas Jefferson of Virginia was charged with drafting a formal statement justifying the 13 colonies' break with Great Britain. The document was drafted by a committee of five: Thomas Jefferson of Virginia, John Adams of Massachusetts, Ben Franklin of Pennsylvania, Robert Livingston of New York, and Roger Sherman of Connecticut. Jefferson drew up a draft and included Franklin's and Adams' corrections. After submission to Congress, the draft version of the Declaration of Independence was edited again, with 86 changes by the whole Congress. 56 members of Congress eventually signed it. At the time, the Declaration of Independence was regarded as a collective effort of the Continental Congress. Jefferson was not recognized as its principal author until the 1790s. It's time to talk about food. Americans consume around 155 million hot dogs on the 4th of July each year. And they also spend $92 million on chips, $167 million on watermelon, and $341 million on beer. By the way, July 4th is America's top beer drinking holiday. The total? Americans plan to spend $6.8 billion on food and drink for this July 4th. There have been 27 different official versions of the U.S. flag since the first one in 1777. Our first official flag had 13 stars representing the 13 original colonies, and the 13 stars were placed in the circle to represent unity and equality. More stars were added as each state was entered into the Union. The current 50-star flag debuted on July 4, 1960, after Hawaii became a state. Americans who proudly fly Old Glory on the 4th of July can thank a Lancaster, Ohio Boy Scout for the current design of the flag. Robert Heft designed and sewed the prototype for a class project at Lancaster High School. As the famed story goes, Heft's teacher gave him a B- on the project, but issued a challenge. If you can get the U.S. Congress to accept the flag, the grade will be changed to an A. Bob did get his A 2 years later when President Eisenhower called him up to let him know his design has been selected as the official U.S. flag. So there you have it, 13 short colonial facts to share with your family and friends while eating your hot dogs and drinking your beer on our national holiday. I welcome your comments and suggestions for new marker stories. If history can be taught with stories, it can never be forgotten. Please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell to stay informed on the latest videos. And don't forget to leave your comments and suggestions below for what markers you want to see next.